prophesied in Zechariah that Jesus would come in, that the Messiah would come in on a donkey, riding a donkey. It's a humble position to prophesy this way. It was a build-up. Because Jesus really didn't. In some ways, he knew what it would mean if he would come to Jerusalem. And this is right after he came in. He says, "The hour is coming for the Son of Man to be glorified. What shall I say? Father, save me from this hour." No, it was for this very reason I came to this hour. So, if you read the Gospel of John, it talks about how his first mentions this in John chapter 2 with the turning of the water into wine, and he told his mother about his hour hadn't come yet. You know, it's like you're quickening by hour. And that once the miracle started, he knew it was going to unravel. And then there were different occasions throughout the Gospel of John. One occasion they were going to push him over the hill and kill him. You remember that occasion? Mm-hmm. It says they couldn't do it. They were prevented to do it because it wasn't his hour. Which is very interesting. And there's this theme through the Gospel of John about hour. An hour means not 60 minutes. I think we know that. It means time. It means this period of time. He says, for this period of time he came. So what's the big deal? He says, this is the hour. What happened? What happened on Palm Sunday? What's the big deal? Cloaks down. That would keep the dust down in those days because there were dusty roads. It's also like, sort of like rolling out the red carpet, I guess. You're putting your cloaks down. And they said, "Hosanna," which means, "Lord, save us." Hosanna. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. And they were making him king, and then later, in about a week, the same crowd was, I'm imagining, the same crowd, same crucified him. It's interesting how things turn. As Jesus entered Jerusalem, he went to the temple. Why did he go directly to the temple? What was so important or special about the temple? What's at the temple? That's not why you went to the temple.
It's a house of God.
Okay, and what makes it the house of God? What makes it the house of God?
God's presence.
Yeah. And where's God's presence? In the Holy of Holies, behind the curtain, behind this thick curtain, exactly how thick it is hugely thick. It goes from the top of the temple all the way down to the bottom, and the high priest, once a year, is able to go in there for the sins of the people. He sprinkled blood on the altar. But the presence of God is there. So Jesus goes to the temple. Remember the first time that it's talked about that Jesus entered the temple and was at the temple? Remember that? When he was 12 years old? He went to the temple because his parents made the trek. they went, and then they were going home. And after so many days, they realized Jesus ain't with us. I'm not sure how many kids they had at that time. I'm not sure who was supposed to see him or be able to take a hold of him. They went back to Jerusalem. Now, Jerusalem is kind of, I mean, there's a lot of crooks and crannies in Jerusalem. It's not necessarily just a TV city. So they looked everywhere. Probably looked where they stayed, asked different people that they thought they'd met. And lo and behold, they finally went into the temple. That's where Jesus was, of all places, to find Jesus. Where would you find a 12-year-old boy, you think? He's in the temple. That's where he is. Wow. Remember what his parents said? Something to the effect, why'd you do this to us? He says, basically, where do you think I'd be? I'm doing my father's business. And in there, he's talking to the chief priests and the other teachers that were there. And it says they were astounded at what came out of his mouth. They didn't realize that this was the Messiah, 12 years old, talking to them. They were astounded. Jesus connected with the Heavenly Father and is disconnected with his earthly father at age 12. He said, wow, this kid's in a different place. This boy's in a different place. I'm reaching Jerusalem, Jesus entered the temple courts and began driving out those who were buying and selling there. He overturned the temple tables of the money changers and the benches of those selling doves, and would not allow anyone to carry merchandise through the temple courts. As he taught them, he says, is it not written, my house will be called a house of prayer for all nations? But you have made it a den of robbers. How to win friends and influence people, huh? This is our next leader. Jesus took over and made a scene. He drove out people. He overturned tables, stopped the flow, stopped the traffic flow of merchandise, and he taught all who would listen. What is he doing? Why is he doing this? What's going on? Why is he doing this? It's not like he asked for permission, or he began talking to the different leaders and saying, hey, not that he probably hadn't tried to do it before, but he didn't hang out in Jerusalem. He just went right to the temple and started. Why did he do this?